Student, welcome to the course of electric power distribution and utilization. We are studying the chapter that is the distribution system. We have studied about the different distribution system types, that is the AC distribution system and DC distribution system. Today we are going to study the connection scheme of distribution system. So all the distribution of electrical energy is done by a constant voltage system. As we have studied in our last lecture, that there is a plus six and -6% variation is acceptable, but not more than that. In practice, the following distribution circuits are generally used. The first one is the radial system. In a radial system, a separate feeder from a single substation is used, which feed the distribution at one end only. This is the single line diagram of a system. This one shows the distribution system in DC, and this shows the distribution system in AC. As seen, we have a substation and it is feed the feeder at one end, that is point A. Here is the distribution transformer, and then we have loads. So in this system, a separate feeder from a single substation that feed the distribution at one end only is you people seen in figure, the single line diagram of radial system for both AC and DC distribution system, where a feeder OC supply a distributor AB at point A. The radial system is used or employed only when the power is generated at low voltage and the substation is located at the center of the load. In the substation near the load, and when the power is generated at low voltage. This is the simplest distribution circuit and has lowest initial cost. However, it has some drawbacks. The end of the distributor nearest to the feeding point will be heavily loaded, and the consumer are dependent on a single feeder and single distributor, as we have one single system. Therefore, any fault on a feeder or distributor cut off supply to the consumer who are on the side of the fault away from the substation. Next thing is that the consumer at the distant end of the distributor would be subjected to a serious voltage fluctuation as different taping is taken when the load on the distributor changes, being load variation. Due to these limitations, this system is used for short distance only. Next one is the ring main system, is the name implies that this system, the primaries of the distribution transformer, form a closed loop. So the loop circuit start from the substation bus bar, making a loop through the area to be served and return to the substation. This is single line diagram of the ring main system. We have the substation and this form a loop from S, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R and back to S. Here is explanation. The figure shows a single line diagram of a ring main system for AC distribution where the substation supply to the closed feeder L, M, N, O, P, Q, or S. The distributor are taped from different point of the feeder to the distribution transformer. The ring main system has the following advantages. So these are the distributor are taped from point M, O, N, Q to a distribution transformer. And its advantage is that there is a less fluctuation at a consumer terminals. The system is very reliable. Each distributor is fed by two feeder. In the event of fault on any section of the feeder, the continuity of the supply is maintained. So that is its main advantage. Suppose we have a fault here, F, in this area. So, for example, the fault at section SLM, that means from the substation. This area having a fault. So then the section SLM of the feeder can be isolated for maintenance and repair, and at the same time the continuity of the supply is maintained to all the consumers by the feeder SP2 PONM from here S R Q P O N N and this way in the anti-clockwise direction. The last one is the interconnected system. It is a type of system when the feeder ring is energized by the two or more than two generating station. We have more than one generating station or substation. It is called the interconnected system. In a figure, the diagram is shown as we have this substation 1 and substation 2. The rest is similar to the previous system. And it's all, where the closed feeder ring ABCD is supplied by the two substation S1 and S2 at point D and C respectively. Distributed or connected to the points O, P, Q and R of the feeder ring to the distribution transformer. The interconnected system has the following advantages. It increases the service reliability, and any area feed from one generating station during peak load hour can be feed from the other generating station having less load. So this increases the efficiency of the system. So these are the different scheme of distribution system: the interconnected system, the ring main system, and radial system. Each one have its advantages and disadvantages. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.